made sense after I read that. There were Einsteins who never became Einstein. There were Michael Jordans who never became Michael Jordans. And they lay out in the graveyard, having died, and never fulfilled their potential. Mm. That's what I want to talk to you today about. I want to talk to you today about being the best you that God has created you to be. And in scripture based on a lot of lessons on this scripture based. It becomes Ephesians 2:10. I'll read it quickly. For we are his workmanship. We were created in Christ Jesus unto good work, which God had ordained that we should walk in them. In other words, what this scripture is saying, let me see. What this scripture is saying is that God created us for greatness.
Yes.
Don't you want to be the best you that you can be? But as you look around, and the one who's speaking to you today, I don't want you to do what I did. When I look back over my life, I have many regrets. Even though things turned out well for me, I realized that it could have been so much more better. Mm-hmm. And many of these adults, if they were honest with you, they would tell you too that they're not all that they should be. Some of us were great athletes, but we never put in the work to take it to the next level. Some of us had great minds, but we just did enough to make the B, the C, and we never really pursued excellence. When we look back, then we have regrets. I don't want you to live your life in that way. I want you to make a conscious decision today to become all that God would have you.
Yeah.
Now, I don't want to tell you that without telling you how to do it. The first thing that you need to do is this. You need to realize you're not there yet. One of my problems was I thought I was all that and a bad shit. I'm just being real with you. I'm going to be real with you. I'm new way. I thought I was bad. You may be better than everybody on side of you, but you're not there yet. You may be the prettiest person in the class. You may be the most athletic person in the class, but the biggest room in the world is the room for improvement.
Yes, sir.
There's always room to be better than we are right now. But here's the thing I see among them. I'm black, so I can talk about black folks. About us. Here's the thing I see about us. Our greatest problem is this. We are unteachable beings. I see people come out to my job all the time, and young boys, they'll only know how to tie their shoes or wear a belt to work. And they come out the first day, they want to tell you what to do. You've been doing it 18, 20 years. And it always just blows me away that they would even have the mentality. The first thing you do is sit down, be quiet, and observe, listen, learn, and apply. And we go into the schoolhouse with the same mentality.
Yeah.
Children coming home, let me tell you, don't years old. But guess what? You'll never learn how to read until you grasp the concept that is the apple. You see, this is important. It may not be important to you now.
Yeah.
This stuff that they're going to teach you on the conference, how to edit your skin and how to present yourself in the workplace. It may not be important to you now, but the day will come where you're going to need this stuff. So if you're going to be great, you have to have a teachable skill. Maybe I can't tell you that, but there's got to be somebody in this church who's able to maybe you don't receive it from me. I'm okay with that. I don't, whoever can be a blessing to my child, I'm all for.
Amen.
I don't have to be the one to reach you, but whoever can help them, I'm all for. But if you're going to be great, you have to have a teachable spirit. Little Brad told me he wants to go out for basketball last year, and I'm going to tell you something, he played good enough to make the team. But last year, he didn't make the team, and I let him collapse. Because I told him, I said, son, I played basketball. I know what it takes. My coach would take us way down on the bus and drop us about 2 miles down the road. Go back with the bus to the school and get his car and drive behind you as you ran. You had to run back to the school.
Yeah.
You had one of the little calls. You couldn't get in there if you wanted to. And I told him, I said, you know what? It, just having the ability is not enough. But you have to put in the work. So this year, now I'm glad that he got touched. And guess what? I already knew what time it was because he wasn't in no condition. This year, he'll make it. Because even before the trial's not here, I got him beating the pavement. I tell him, next time, we need to put some work in. And I go sit on the truck, and I point that way, and I tell him I'm going to run. Then when he comes back, I'm good to go. If you're going to be great, you have to start preparing for greatness.
Amen.
Now,
amen.
You see this young man here? You see how he can play? He was good when he was 10 years old. I saw him. But he's a whole lot better now.
Amen.
And you just play this, man. You play this, man. You're never going to become great if you don't prepare for greatness now. Before I bought a house, I bought furniture for the house.
Mm-hmm.
You got to know, you got to have a vision. And you got to prepare for that vision to come into fruition. In other words, I didn't wait till I got there and then I'm, well, let me see. No, I bought all the furniture. I had stuff, me and my wife had about this much room between the place that we were renting and the wall. The bed was, the people said, we can't sit in the bed without the trial. And the guys that moved it out, they said, man, we're never going to move you again. I had the big TV, I had it in a box in a corner with a sheet over it. I was prepared for the day that, and my mother said, where'd you get all that stuff from? It was in the house before. But it wasn't time to use it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And when it came time to transition, I was able to transition easy.
Amen.
Some of the work that you're putting in, you're going to school now. Not for now. You're going to school now for your future.
Nice.
The habits that you're performing. Let me tell you something. You don't, if a young girl don't clean up a room as a young girl, she's probably going to be a pretty nasty wife. He's private. That's a harsh word. That's a good thing that he may become a trifling young man. If he's an irresponsible teenager, unless he's tweaked, unless he accepts the teaching and learning to make him different, he's probably going to be an irresponsible man. It does not start then, it starts right now. Let me close this saying this. Let me tell you something. What I see, and I don't think it's just me. You guys have so much potential.
Amen.
So much potential. I see greatness in this church.
Amen.
I'm not just remember all this. She's got a better memory than me. But I used to watch her. I watched her spirit. I watched her do a prayer meeting in the room. Nobody was there. She was real. She was real. That's why I didn't think I could be a Christian. She was so real. But she did little things like she never wasted anything. She got two pieces of cornbread. She put it in a container. Bargain. Put it in the box. And you think you can eat something real special for Thanksgiving. All it was, all that leftover garbage. I said, I don't need nothing for us. Now, we don't feel like that now. That's why we're in debt right now. Not that you don't have enough, we waste everything that God has given us. Oh, we've been with it. Garbage can. We don't eat this and we don't eat that. What you want to eat and all that stuff. Let me tell you something. You better lose that mentality or you're going to be poor. Oh, P-O-D. I know how to spell poor. I just don't want nothing to do with it. Listen, it didn't make no sense to me. I mean, why she say that one piece of cornbread? Turn that fan on. Turn that light on. Now I'm telling my children, turn them lights off. You ain't in that room. Why you let that light on? The same stuff she was teaching me, I'm now teaching my children. So I'm trying to tell you, don't reject what your parents are trying to put in you. Last thing, don't go. I tell the guys all the time, I use this analogy on my job. I say, don't go walking behind the donkey. Leave the donkey. Don't follow the donkey. You know what, donkey? A donkey is not too smart. Don't you go hook up. I don't know what it is. I was like that too. No, I was at the class clown. And there were people that would gravitate from good homes. And I mean, their mother was whipping them. They're like, you better leave that. I had that parents say, you ain't going to be running with that boy. So I just act like that because my parents was old. They didn't, you know, they didn't come to school. I act like that at school. But I didn't act like that at home. Oh, they didn't bother that in my house. But listen, don't go following the donkey. If you meet a fool, run from him. I'm serious. Run from him. You clown, you clown, and you won't be this free. But that makes you bird of a feather, because I'm not sure of fly. If you meet a fool, get so far away from me, you don't know what's going to happen to a fool. You can't become great following food. Let me tell you something. Greatness is not something that everybody's going to attain. It's a rare quality. So if you're doing what everybody else is doing, probably ain't making you be great. If you want to be popular, you probably ain't going to be great. Greatness is it's a rare quality. Listen, God has put his time. The Bible, I just mentioned, it said that God created us for greatness.
Yes.
I wish I could redeem some of the things that I have destroyed. I wish I could go back and undo some of the things that I have done. But I found a way to redeem some of it. Tell somebody else so that they won't make the mistake that I made. Children, God knows I love you. God knows that the Lord loves you without a doubt. You're going to have to make up your mind whose report you're going to receive. The prophet said that we're going to receive the report of the Lord. God said when he created man that you are good. And you are good. You just got to shake those bad habits. Each and every one of you have the potential to become great. We need to go after and pursue greatness. God bless you.
Amen.
Come on, y'all.
I can get that download for you, but there's some stuff I can use on Saturday. Yeah. I might have to come on back and say it again. Thank you, Rev Chaney. You bless us. You can just bless the children.